catch your fish in Call of the Wild. The angler with Dr. Fish. Me today. There you go. That's what we got. That's the link if you want to check out the game. We'll be doing some dares along the way so I can give you copies of this game so you can fish. Hey Clayton, how you doing? Hey Yoshi, what's up? So, you might see that I'm drinking not coffee. I'm still drinking my breakfast. I was a bit slow, I realized. I checked my clock, and I'm like, barely eating breakfast, and it's 5 minutes to stream. All right, well, little segment. This is my cultured milk, infused with... What's solbær in English? Solbær. Black currant. Hey, Patty. Okay, let's fish. Let's do it. Let's see if I can actually fish. Like in a real new modern fishing game. Okay. I've not set this up at all. Let's set it up while we go, huh? That's better. Professionalism. Yeah, put the drink in front of the stream deck. That's gonna help, Golem. Hold on. Ahaha, there we are.
What is it about your hobby that keeps you coming all the way out here?
Fishing.
Is it the freedom?
No, it's fishing.
Wandering in search of that perfect spot.
Open world, the fishing experience.
These hills.
Wow.
Tasted the fresh water of our lakes, our rivers. You've been on the water with friends at sunrise and helped the locals long past sunset.
Oh, Patty.
But you just keep coming back.
Poor Patty.
Oops, my
at
chrome
this
is...
spot, you got a pretty good idea what's lurking beneath the surface.
Yeah, fish and boots.
But there's only one way to find out. Whether it's the one you ride home about or the one that gets away... That feeling is what gets you hooked.
I'm so scared.
That whether it's your first time or your 100th time, you never know what you're gonna catch.
You never know what you're
until
gonna
it's
get.
Caught.
Maybe you're not all using the right lure, you dingus.
The angler.
The angler. Call of the Anglo Wild. Geese. There are geese migrating outside. I wonder if this is going to be good with the gamepad. Hey, is this Bolano? Poor Patty, it's... You're usually up at 11 p.m. in your time. And you're usually up to 9 a.m. That's a bit... Yeah, if you're like out with vacation with people and you're a night crawler. That's boring. You can stay and fish with us. I'm back to fishing. Yeah, I had the sponsored opportunity at Daredrop, and after our 50 fishing game, I thought, you know what? Why not? Like, this game wouldn't usually fit me, but you know what? Let's get money and let's fish. Skip account. No worries if you change your mind. I'm not gonna change my mind. I don't like an account. I like to be a free range, free roaming, freelancing fisherman. Everything free. money and fish. Money fish. Hey, Thane. Good to see him. I can't wait till I sneakily capture an outpost and catch a legendary fish. So, of course, the first dare is as simple as it should be. Catch my first fish. Fish. Catch a fish. And we're going to focus on that. Right? Don't need to overcomplicate things. That might be difficult enough. Fisk. Gefilte fisk. One. Two. Play. New reserve available. Trollspore. It's in Norway. Wow. What? But this is like new and scary. But I have to go to Trollspore. No, don't. No. No, it's a DLC. How much is it? Whoa, it's not the cheapest DLC. It's going to be more expensive than I get out of this sponsor, most likely. Fuck. We're going to do Golden Ridge Reserve. Fine. Oh, I'm in the way of these beautiful people. Let's see here. Golden Ridge Reserve is a beautiful national park. I can serve my face here. But with many different areas to explore, from the wide blue lake basins of Emerald Lake Plateau to the rust-colored hills of Ruby River Range. Not to mention the gorgeous flower-covered fields of Silver Strand Meadows. There is something for everyone here. And we can get Clayton Johnson, Golden Ridge Reserve Warden, or in Sophia Taylor, proprietor of Taylor's Tackles. Taylor Tackle, diddly dangling. Quick hype train? Yeah, quick, just fund Golem's Trollspore. I don't want to use your cash to get Trollspore, chat. Egg low track. So many currencies. That's an insane amount of currencies. No.
And when was the first time you noticed something's wrong?
I don't want.
Well,
no,
when
I'm not.
I first heard the shot, and as I turned, Jim fell.
Yeah, he's a teller, Frank.
Thank you, Jim.
Jim told the teller.
No, Jim Johnson.
Who's Jim Fell? Yeah, he's the auditor, Frank.
He had the flu, so Jim filled in.
Phil who?
Phil did.
I'm not. No, we're gonna get it. Bye, Chester.
Now wait a minute.
Am I held hostage?
Twice came in and shot the teller, and Jim fell.
No, he only shot the teller. Jim Johnson fell as ill.
Okay, then after he shot the teller, you shot twice.
No, I only shot once.
Twice is the holdup, man.
Then I guess I did shoot twice.
Well, then I changed the story.
No, I shot twice after Jim fell.
You shot twice and Jim fell?
No, Jim fell first, and then I shot twice once.
Who fired twice?
Once.
He's the owner of Frank, the tire company, Frank.
Okay. Once is the owner of the tire company, and he fired twice. Then twice shot the teller once.
Twice.
And Jim fell, and then you fired twice.
Once.
Sorry.
Okay. All right, that'll be all for now, Miss Decker.
For your DLC needs.
No!
Bibby's Golem Glee.
Glee! Thank you, Yoshi, for the 100 bids. No! You're not! You're not gonna shame me into buying Trollspore DLC. Thank you for the 150 fish bits
fishing
thing.
Fishing is calling, Golem Button.
Fishing is calling. It is indeed. I want it, but I can't. That's too much, guys. You can't. Thank you so much for the support. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate it. But we can't. That's too trollspore. That sounds nice, though. Oh. Hey, gifted. Thank you for the gift, Subdraforan, to Citrus Punch for life. About. Oh, that is the about page, isn't it? Oh, look at all those fish we can caught. Legendary fish? Oh shit, we can get shinies? This is cool. Stats, biggest catch. Big Larry. Sidewinder. Goldstein. Berenstein. Stain Goldstein Bears. Maybe check out the game first. Okay, let's put it like this, chat. If it's really cool, then we can fund Trollspore, okay? Okay. But I'm gonna probably rage at the fish. Hold on. We need to become the fish master. I haven't retired you yet. How do I do it? It's... the fish are fucked up. Ah, shit. Oh, the hair is caught 50. In the thing. The hair of my previous enemy. There it is. It ripped out some of my hair and it's used my hair as a knotting mechanism. God, it ripped out so much hair. Ow. It's stuck in the hair it ripped out of me. That's so bad. I told you I sacrificed myself for this thing. Streaming. We're back. We're back fishing. Wait, is the stream broken? No? It's just on my end. The game is a force to be reckoned with, okay? It's one of these insanely accurate games. Look at that foliage, though. Yeah, it's just my browser.
Taylor from Taylor's Tackles here, and I hear you're in need of a little fishing refresher. Well, let me tell you, you've come to the right place. Although, another right place to go would be Taylor's Tackles, right down at the Central Outpost. Can't miss it.
Thank you for the gift sub to Fishing is Life, Jester Frog. Appreciate it. Welcome to the Golden Ridge Reserve. To ease you in, you'll be presented with some short explanations and instructions. These instructions will cover the controls and how to catch your first few fish. Fish. Once you finish the tutorial, you will be connected to online multiplayer automatically. No.
Now, first things first.
Chat, do not, if you engage me in fishing, I will have you. Move to the jetty. But I'm scared. I don't want to catch... I'm scared about these fish. I don't own these fish. Don't, if this is a Dark Souls fishing game, I am done. You're not gonna invade and challenge my fish, okay?
I see you've brought your own rod. Can't get anywhere if you don't take it out, so you do the honors.
Invader defeated.
So, let's start off with a simple cast. Keep those shoulders and hips square for me.
Oh shit, I'm in the way of fishing information. I'm fishing intel. Where should I go? Over here? We'll see. We're over here now. Okay. Hold, how to cast, hold left trigger and move back, then move forward.
Heh. Bah. Yeah.
You should release the trigger.
No.
I'm just LARPing some Harry Potter right here.
Expelliarmus! Fish go crunkodingus! Fish dedicus maximus! Pisco pasco pilido!
Reel it in. Take your time. Get used to it.
Hey, Pine. Who gave this man a wand?
My father.
Look at this new modern fishing gear.
Now we're fishing for real. I'd like to see a nice.
She said for real.
Strike as soon as she bites and reel her in when she's tired.
I don't need a life vest. I am life. Wait for fist to approach. Nibble and bite. When the indicator says strike, press right trigger.
Whoa!
You strike too early! Strike too early! Strike! Strike! Focus. Yes. Oh, come on. Oh, I need to see more. Nibble, nibble, bite. Okay. Shh, chat. Shh. Nibble. Come on, nibble. That's a nibble. Nibble.
Bite! Strike! You're out! Whoa, hold on there. Woo! Crazy fish! Come on, crazy fish! Woo! Hey! Come on, it's a marlin!
I did not create this character. I did not create this character. I did not do anything. What? Can I create my character? I did not create. No. No, this is. I did not create this. I didn't. Score one. Who is this? Did I do that when I set up the game? I can't remember that. I guess that's what we look like. She's got a great beard. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm not okay. I mean, to each his own. I am the bearded fish lady. I guess we're all about that, you know? How did you catch such a big fish? Because I give him a big fishman. Who's that? It's cousin Golem. She's had a ride. Catching fish will earn you XP and credits. Credits allow you to buy new equipment and apparel from the shop. Earn enough XP and you will level up, unlocking additional equipment in the shop.
Congratulations! She's a beauty. The fish here aren't yours to keep, so even if you love her, you gotta let her go.
I can't hear you.
Fishy, fishy, fish.
Greet the shopkeeper. Follow the path to the shop. It's an open world gaming. Wow, this is actually pretty.
Toasty! Whoa! I feel so alive! Fishing!
You were hoping it was about the book. There's a book, Call of the Wild? Now I have like my breakfast drink and my coffee. I don't know what to do. Located new lookout tower. We can explore, chat. It's time for a world, a wonderful world, Bo. To explore the locations of Mr. Fish. Look at the place it's rendering in slowly. It's got mountains, giant and fish smaller than them. It's the time of my old life. I got kicked out by the wife and I'm sleeping on the couch. Survey.
Golden Ridge Reserve. What's in the name, huh? Well, this one dates all the way back to the late 18th century. French trappers named the park Crête d'Or.
Crack Door? What was his name? Oh, nice. I went to see a doctor about that thyroid. Shut up. No, we're good. I'm happy about how my looks. This is a good looking game. An open world game as well. You know, I'll add it to the pin to be cool. The message we had earlier. This is the link to the game. I mean, this, I didn't even check the link. This is fine. That is okay. I'll pin it. Manually unpin. Call up the wild. I'll keep it. Because it'll look, if anybody picks on me, then I can say like, oh, you're gonna pick on people that are dyslexic. That's cool. And then people will feel bad and they'll donate. Wow, it's actually pretty damn detailed, what the fuck? Gamers, screw Red Dead Redemption 2, 3, I mean.
The Central Reserve Outpost. This ain't just any outpost. You'll find all the bells and whistles here, like Taylor's Tackles, a brand new shop run by my friend Sophia. Other than that, you'll be able to find notice boards, storage lockers, a boathouse, and a garage for easy access to transportation, plus a flagpole for yourself.
This guy can't time? Wow, man. Patty just hurt my feelings, chat. I'm dyslexic. I'm not really dyslexic. I'm just really bad at reading. I don't know what it is. I've never checked, though. For me, it's mostly the numbers. I'm hurt and I need money. By the way, I just got information about how much money I'll be paying extra a month for the renovations, and it's gonna suck. So, I'll be up to, as soon as I know everything what's going on, chat, about the renovations and where I can move and such like that, I will inform you guys on the update video. But right now, I still don't know everything, so I'd rather make one video about it. But basically, it's gonna increase by $110 in 2 months' time. Then it's gonna increase further, additional $150. So I'm looking at paying close to $300 extra per month just because of the renovations.
So I'm, and then worst case scenario, I'm gonna have to live and rent at the friend's place, which is gonna cost me approximately, I don't know yet, but maybe $400. So I'm looking at paying $700 extra a month. So I'm actually kind of fucked. But we'll see what happens. But yeah, if shit ain't good, but you know, I'll figure it out. But if it's worst to worst, then I'll just get I don't want to look for an extra job, right? Because it's kind of like, it's in between. It's just a time. I mean, just like a specific moment in time where it's going to cost extra. The loan is going to cost extra for a while, but we'll see. But yeah, I'm trying to think positive, and hopefully we get an opportunity to just keep going normal, even though I have to move around a bit. We'll see. Voyage Blue Rat. Voyage Blue Rat is a tried and tested off-road vehicle that readily tackles all weather conditions with its patented Quattro Plus system. The Quattro Plus system offers low-range capability that won't leave you in the lurch when you have somewhere to be, culminating in a hardy, versatile workhorse of a 4x4. Call. You called your car. Move to the left door and press X to enter the driver's seat. But why was I supposed to enter the tackle shop first? I completely forgot about that. Let me do that later. Hello, it's your Bugatha. So yeah, it's gonna be like at the start of next year, basically. We're gonna look at an interesting time. I'm gonna be super fucking busy because here's a couple of summarizations of what's gonna happen. By February, January, I'm going to have to move out for the renovations. My loan, I'm gonna start paying full on my loan again, because I'm at that age where I have to close out the... There's like a very good bank, which you can save it for like anything that's related to buying your apartment, but that ends when you the year you get to be 34, which is next year. So I have to cancel that. I have to pay more on my loans. I pay down the loan from that account, and then potentially, well, it's the increased payments per month for rent at this place, and then potentially also for the place that I have to live in, I have to pay for. So it's gonna be a fuck ton of stuff and a lot of expenses. I just hope I can survive it. Wait, did I just go the wrong way through shopping? That was towards the car though. What the hell? Didn't it just tell me to go up here? And then I'm going down here again? Or was it just over the mountain, maybe? Give fishing lessons. You're right, I should start giving fishing lessons from a carriage.
Nice to put a fish to a face.
Nice day for fishing, ain't it?
Can I interest you in a
bar? Not again! These guys love Norway, man. They got a DLC for it. Maybe Norwegians did make this game.
Used to visit here as a kid. It's just like I remember it.
These are so high quality. Perk and Kins. Bait and tackle, but it feels brand new. Tackle for those that appreciate it. Is it used? But it feels brand new. No. Hey, Saxman. Thank you for 21 months. These look ancient. Why are you selling ancient lure?
different than Seattle, but boy, is it beautiful.
Minnow bait. Got it. Don't look bad at lady and not in the eyes. Let me pay. Beep boop 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 boop. Okay.
Wonder why old Bigfoot has decided to rear his head now of all times, huh?
Yeah, what Bigfoot is dead. Gone. I mean, back soon. We should be able to jump over this. Ha! Maybe if we use this sign. Can I run? No.
But I want to look at the bear.
No. One more shot. Use the fishing rod like a grappling hook and swing from the roof. I can use it as my prosthetic and Sekiro across.
Sekiro. Sekiro.
10 fish limit. No more than 10 fish a pop. Catch another fish. This game seems to be easy to fish in, huh? All the details now. We need that legendary fish. I guess we did catch our first fish. I forgot to do that. But that was kind of a tutorial, wasn't it? Boat rentals, Golden Ridge Reserve. 307-555 boat. Lionheart, Mariner, Ultra Cruiser with, I get an old guy with the cruiser though. That's kind of a bargain. This map should clearly be updated. Simply walk onto it and you'll be automatically seated. But I want to just catch a fish, sorry. How do I propose rod? Propose rod. Extend rod. Got it.
Expelliarmus.
Focus.
Hello, Vivi.
Will it work? I don't see any fish. I see a fish. Nibble.
Fishing, fish, did a scooter bear. Got a fisherman, little bear.
This is so easy compared to the games we play, Chad. God, it always surprises me. Who am I? Baits, lures, and hooks. Well done. Swapping your bait and lure is a good strategy to use if you're not getting any bites. Want to try catching different species. Changing hooks will affect the size of the fish that bite. Small fish will not bite bigger hooks. They might be stupid, but not that stupid. The monster. That's what they call me. Yeah, I figured the Hat King is back. Hey, Seraphim. Dragon tension. Managing dragon line tension is important when catching bigger fish. Too much tension, the line could snap to a little drag, and the fish will start swimming away. Tension is viewed in the circle in the bottom right corner of the screen. Also forgot to catch fish again. What graphics engine is this? I have no idea. Pretty good. Can vary your drag by using the left and right in the kitch, in the fish catching. Kitch fashing. You don't see the drag right now, but it's not very sexy to look at. I'm just dragging. You can see it on the right side. There you go. You can see like, too much drag. Come here, you dingus. It's getting away. Come on. There he is. Yeah, there you go. Come on. Come on now. No. Too much drag. Come on now. Come on. Gotcha. I'll have to do a thing now. Now, this is not officially our first fish. This is our third fish, but the first time I'm doing three fish and first time I'm making a clip out of getting a fish. Fish! Got it. I'm allowed to do this. I am my own person. Look at me. I'm beautiful. Look at me. I'm beautiful. I'm just dangerous. Look at that laggy mix-up screen. That's lovely. I love it. Hold on a second. You know what, Chrome? You've been surpassed. You can leave entirely. Hold on a second. My computer is suffering because of fission. That's fine. That's the way I like it. I don't want to live forever. The most important thing is you get to see the fish. My computer doesn't necessarily need to work that well. Wow. It's really not working that well. It's a fish sacrifice. I can't even browse on my damn browser, chat. Look at how this is impressive. I'm trying to scroll. Look at this. Oh, yes. Okay, so we have catching your first fish. And then we got take a boat out on the lake. We know we can do that. And then three bronze ranked fish. Easy peasy. Well done. A higher drag increases the stopping power of your reel, preventing fish from taking the line. It also increases the line tension, which is a double-edged sword. A high tension will tire the fish faster, but also puts the line at risk of snapping. Sometimes the fish will be too large for the gear and require a stronger tackle. Greet the warden. Hello, warden. How are you, warden? Call of the wild, the angler man. Call of the angler man.
Well, well, I take it you got my message. Welcome to the reserve, Buckaroo.
Warden of Golden Ridge Reserve works to protect the environment in the park. He asks visitors to keep an eye open for invasive plant species, diseased trees, and malfunctioning equipment, among other things. If you see one of these objects, you can interact with them to let the warden know.
That Sophia knows all there is to know about fishing, and that's good for business. But there's a way we do things around here, and she don't get it.
I like his hat. Help Clayton preserve the reserve by reporting objects of interest you find while fishing and traveling. Report any instances of invasive plant to the Bledka Scuba Cava.
Here's your bread.
Here's your bread.
Daisies are the thorn in the side of sweet mother nature. Pale, mangy weeds. Can't miss them if you wanted to. Now for the butter. Engelmann's spruce beetle infestations. Horrible little creepy crawlies that'll rip a forest apart in a flash. And finally, bread and butter ain't squat to a big sizzling hunk of meat. Personally, I reckon bones are useless without tasty flesh attached. But them tourists love a crusty Stegosaurus. So keep a lookout. Don't go out of your way, but if you're fishing and you
Stegosaurus?
Let me know.
What is this game? Are we fishing dinosaurs? He can't just... Did he scratch his ass there? I saw you scratching your ass. I saw him scratching. You can't... I know when a man is scratching. Hey, Modest Mouse, how you doing? He was scratching. But we're apparently catching a Stegosaurus. Take a mission from the challenge board. Catch a T-Rex with a fishing hook? Fuck. Fish up a Megalodon. Megalodon. While sightseeing the dinosaurs. Welcome to Call the Fucking Wild. Challenge board holds different types of challenges and other calls to action. There's a challenge board at every outpost in the reserve. As you complete challenges, more will unlock. There are three different types of challenges. Each one involves finding a location and catching a specific fish. This board also has two unique missions. The Golden Tour leads you around to the key locations in the reserve, while Taylor's Tackle Academy teaches the fishing mechanics in detail. These missions are recommended for new players. Okay, cool. Taylor's Tackle Academy. Okay. Welcome to Taylor's Tackle Academy. In this series of missions, you'll be taught the basics of the game. Our four classes? Oh, I thought you were going to pick the wizard fish, the warrior fisherman, the rogue fisherman, and then, of course, the priest. Fishing for the wild for the priest. Each involving a series of objectives followed by a challenge. Recommended for beginners, you're able to follow these classes for extra information in between your own exploration and fishing. This class will cover float fishing, baits, and hook dip. Lesson will continue when you reach the marked location. You've joined multiplayer for the first time. By default, you will automatically connect to a server and join people from to turn this off, disable this at Apex. I mean, I don't know. I think it's not a good idea. What if it's on? What if, like, people will talk? TTS. Quick. Oh, God. The cabin is... Okay. Activity reports, name tags. What if we just take off messages? If we don't see anybody join. And we just don't... Text chat. Activity report for text chat. I don't know what the fuck's going on. We'll see. We'll just be doing this. And if something happens, we'll take it. We'll change it. It's my core. As someone who has fished, fishermen can say some problematic stuff. Driving the car is done by using right trigger to accelerate.
Woo! Woo! Lovely afternoon for a fish. You know where I am.
I can't actually get out of car view. Change camera. Wow, that's weird. You'd think that you could at least change to, like, You play this game a lot, Shorty? Really? Now go fishing with the car. Oh no! Float fishing uses a float, a hook, and some bait. As the bait is in the water, the float remains on the surface and acts as an indicator whether the fish is nibbling or biting. If nothing bites after a few minutes, you can try reeling in and casting in a different location. I didn't want to go. I didn't want to do that. Oh, I'm all nasty and dirty now. Hello, Mr. Bloodworm. Mr. Bloodworm, catch a fish using your bloodworm. Bloodworm! This is my band, and we're playing music from the Bloodworms! Oh, you shot an... Oh, you shot Call of the Wild. You shot some deer. Oops. That's a problem. Come on now. Come on, fishy. Here, fishy fish. Come on. Nibble a little. Nibble a little bit. Come on, nibble. Ain't no damn fish. Life fish is not on. I am rough and tough. Don't worry about it. Tough, don't worry about it. I don't think there's a fish here. Can we see Splishy Splashy somewhere? The Call of the Wild Hunting Edition. Yeah, the Call of the Wild has many games. The Call of the Wild has Hunter, Call of the Wild has the Angler, and the Call of the Wild Clown Hunting Edition. And Call of the Clown of the Wild. That! There's old damn dingus! Hello?
Fish?
Anybody splishy splashing around here?
Meep. Splishy.
We're here to fish, not be fish.
We were wading too deep. You're not allowed to swim in the reserve.
No. Turn back. No! You can't tell me what to do!
Some fish, please capture me. I want you to be mine. You suck, go away.
Anybody? Anybody?
This game is all about patience. We got some nibbles. Struck! Reeling it in, buddy! Come on, reel it in. It's not providing any tension. Stop looking directly at the camera. Nobody likes that. It's too much. I catch a fish with a bloodworm. What is this rank? I don't know, but we need 3 bronze rank fish. Hook depth. Ah. A lower hook depth allows a bait to reach slightly deeper areas in the water, luring out fish that are swimming deeper or hiding out in nooks and crannies. Like the legendary swimblefish, and Crendel, and of course the fabled Stegosaurus. Can I hook this pole?
You boo!
Change your hook dev using before casting whoopsie daisies. Set the hook dev higher. Catch a fish by float fishing. Not like that. Wait, what was float fishing? It's not me floating, is it? Do I have to float? Is it like a challenge? Is it like a challenge? Like fish, when fishermen can float while fishing, they get like some sort of medal. I don't know. Float fishing. Tell me what to do. Handbook. Just using a bobber. That's what I'm doing. I do have a bobber. That's what I'm doing, isn't it? Look at it. Right? This is a float fish. That's all I did. Hey, Haley. Well, we all right there. We're going to sit there waiting for some fish. Come on now. I ain't see fish. I saw some splishy splashies over here, but maybe that was too late.
Joel. Let him, Joel.
More fishing. More fishing! More fishing. Anybody see splishy splashes? It's a beautiful looking game, man. We're gonna go exploring soon. You know how I get with these open world games. I explore the world. Remember Farming Simulator? That was the best. We were hunting video game cartridges and collecting property in our truck. Wait. That was a big splish. Where did you splish? Was it here? I heard splishy splashy. In all the other games we played on the consoles, they were so tough because you needed to act. You needed to kind of act like the lure. Those were advanced, and now we get this. We're chilling now, hair chat. Three bronze ranked fish. That's another Call of the Wild. You guys can all become fishermen, because now we're racking up these keys. These game keys are for you, champ. And now that's three bronze. We did it. Three bronze fish. You better get your pants tightened. Three bronze fish. The mountains of Kaer Morhen. Get old striding past. He does, actually. If you look closely, every 45 minutes, there is a Geralt in the wild going past. I get 10% off my skill as well. Well done! You learned about float fishing, baits, and hook dev. Next class covers hook size and building your own rig. Be available upon completion of a challenge. Well, let's make sure we get to use that boat, remember? The boat rentals? Let's go back and get the boat, because we had the boat rent. We have a boat there, where we have to boat. Bear Lake. Spam Bear Lake. Where did we write? Where did we meet? Oh, it looks like we did it over here, didn't we? Every pine tree is a parking spot in the wild. Here we go, we boatin'. Woo-wee. Now we're riding the boat. Another clip. Boat music. Yes, cool camera. It's weird that they don't have a third person camera. I should go back to my car so we can explore the wilds. These fish never escapes my face. We need to explore the wilds again, so we need our core. We need our core back. And we can explore the beautiful everything that's there. Jennifer. Jump the duck. I don't know if I can. It naturally slows down. That's how you anchor it. To put it on top of the docks. I couldn't even leave the boat without having to hit land. Exploring the land and seeing what I can do. All right, we got the call back. Let me see my dares. We've taken the boat out on a date on the lake, I mean. Watch the sunset. Aww. Unlock all outposts. All right, that's an exploration thing we can try. What's the most difficult dare there is? Let's see here. What's hard mode? Legendary difficulty. Catch a legendary fish. Catch a diamond fish. 4 hours to catch 4 diamonds. That's legendary difficulty. I sneezed again. These damn fish, I'm telling you. Max your rep score on the Golden Ridge Reserve. Highlights compilation. No, we're good. All right. Hey, Duke. Fish. Do we have a map? I do. Lookout tower. What is this? Undiscovered. We're going on the road. We're discovering this. Coming through. Something to discover. This road system sucks. Did they use a picture of me on the Daredevil website? Did they? I haven't seen that, sir. Show me a screenshot. Mm-hmm. It sounds fishy. That's fine. I'm an idiot. I'm a public idiot. I'm a public idiot. No one is it no more time. Eating fishes, want to catch fish. Eating raw skins, the only thing I like to do with fish. It's best for your liver. This is the graveyard of fish. This is the shortcut. Did I just kill a squirrel? Fast travel location, new trailhead. Look at this. Can I get different cars? No, still the Voyage Blue Ride. Can I call somebody? There's fishing over there too. Look at how detailed these are. You put it in stream clips, yeah, yeah. I'll check it out. Whoops, why is my dude walking? Walking over you, boo-boo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Oh, they have like a community thing. I'm in there? Nice. Ah-ha! Funny. Look, I'm an angry creator, chat. Ellie is there. Who else can we recognize? That's Ellie. Ellie's lovely. You can't see my face anymore. Is that X-Water? Or who's that guy? I think I know that guy too. Oh, it's D's here. And Coco. Look at that. Look at that. Nice. Thank you, sir. Who's that streamer, Mon? Why didn't they choose this picture? It's too early, too late. My saga of fishermen. Oh, somebody caught a big barrel, look at that. Somebody got and cached a big net of barrel. That's impressive. Unluckily, they didn't have anything in the barrel though. Oh man, could have been lucky. Look at me. I'm Shadow Man. Okay, back to exploring. My car is dying. It's actually burning. No, wait. Oh, it's the fireplace. I thought... I've been playing too much GTA, you know? So you see when the car is smoking, it's gonna burn soon and die. But it was actually a bonfire back here. And by the way, why are people leaving bonfires everywhere? Put it off. Declare to appreciate you. Oh, thank you, Seraphim. I love working for Daredrop. They're my favorite people to work for. I probably shouldn't say that live because other people would feel like...
Wait, I thought I was your favorite.
Fuck it. They are. Why is this glitching? Because I take free gigs and I take planned gigs, and their customers, the support people are amazing. So they're just cool. So if you see anybody else doing their sponsors, then just, you know, support them. They're great. When are we going to encounter the Tetradon? This place is huge. Holy shit. Hey, Fortifier.
I need my car back. Can I get my car back? I need my car. If I'm gonna go north, I need my... I think I can get a car from here. Hello? Okay. Good. My car has spawned in. Car, beret, car, car. Let's go.
An actual road. This is so... This looks like a post-apocalyptic. It's pretty early, but you can see the roads are just so deserted. The weather is nice, and the forests are green. It's gonna be a zombie running past. Just this one zombie, and just ignore it. That's probably enough. What all national parks look like. It's a big park. It's a damn big park. I need to get to all the lookout towers though. Unlock all outposts. How many outposts are there? That's lookout towers zone. Why is the game glitching a bit? Is that my game? It's like every there's a couple of frames where it just like stops working. Survey.
Later, American trappers rendered the French name in English as Golden Ridge Reserve. I quite like the old moniker, but hey, the new one's not too shabby.
Oh, and then we see new locations. So the lookouts receive locations, and then we can go to the new locations and then find more looking for. Oh, cool. Look at that! We got all the locations! I love how all these simulator games just have this epic open world now. As a secondary niche. Excuse me. It's just a rental. It's just a rental. It's fine. It's not my car. Take it easy. It's just a rental. Don't worry about it. Yeah, they're getting glitches. Is it just in the car interior? Yeah, I mean, I think you can have a lot of fun in this game. It does at least seem super comfy. With some chill music on the side while just doing all this. Lurking. Watching the video or listening to a podcast. A friend of mine is nuts for Farm Sim. 22, like 4,000 hours. Part of her fun is finding and playing new community maps. Oh, I can get that. It's all about living, you know? Wait, is this... This is a walking path, isn't it? It's a driving path now. New trailhead. Let's see what kind of fish is over here, huh? We've walked long and far now. Where's the ducks? What the ducks? There it is. Oh my Lord, loving the fish. Let's look for splishy splashes first. Splishes? Lishis? Nah, we're just gonna go.
Hey!
Oops, this is... Anything? Looks pretty damn calm to me. Well, nothing. What an expert. We're using different fish. Tackle. What do we got? We're daily challenges. Zero active. Minnows are good. That's a basic one. Is there any explanation of how you should use it? No, there isn't. So I think, like, we learned hard mode. This is like chill fishing. Because now we don't need to, like, act. Because with, like... I would say around 50% or 30% at least of the games that we played during our fishing stream, you had to, like, act. For example, a worm should act like a worm underwater. And they need to be a proper height, and then they need to move in a specific sort of way to, you know, look like that lure you're doing. This is simplifying that by a lot. Hot dog. What? What kind of fish? I guess, you know. Look at it. It's just a hot dog piece. That's cute. This is some sort of new invention. We realize a lot of fishes love hot dog. We're just like humans. Kind of fish, you've gone fishing with hot dog bait. What kind of fish loves hot dogs? Yeah, it's meat. You fish some crawdads using hot dogs. There's realistic fishing and there's too fucking much, yeah. Catfish sauger. Bullhead. Okay, so there's a bunch of them. That's cool. Bass? Bass don't give a shit about hot dog. Huh? Bass like, hey, don't give me that shit. Hot dog? Oh, come on, man. I ain't want that shit. I want some real proper stuff. Got me some jiggin' pork. Got me some frogs. You know, I like the good shit. There was a game that said bass like to... The bass by the lily pods, they also tend to eat frogs. Is it red? I wonder why it's red. Hey, Apexus, how are we enjoying this game, bud? Ah, it's so cozy! I want to kind of listen to all the DMCA tracks now to just make it more cozy.
You're a fish, not be fish.
I'm not a fish, I'm a car! Listening to some bluegrass right now would be nice. Maybe some slow country music. What's musician's favorite fish? A bass. Okay, bass. I mean, very tiny. That's like the lowest. Yeah, you go away now. That's a moment you have to take. You think she's annoying? She's all right. She's barely saying anything, but thanks anyway. She's barely there. Oh, we're going up the mountain. Excuse me? This is off-road. That's a See You Tomorrow Pies, Jed. If you're lucky. What's this thing? That's the dangerous plants. Report.
I thought so. Orange hawkweed. I've had it up to here with them. And you can't see, but I've actually got my hand held real high. Go get rid of them so I can rest my arms, Buckaroo.
How do I get rid of them? I'm gonna leave it. You deal with it, Warden. They look nice, but they're apparently invasive. We don't want that. We're gonna run over with the truck. That's fine. I'm getting rid of it, sir. There we go. That'll deal with those. That should do it. I'll look at tower. Level up! What do I get? Can I do multi-class now? You can now multi-class into wizard. Now, use magic missile on fish to fish faster.
Wow.
That's amazing.
I cast fireball.
You've got 7 fish.
Nice.
The human history of the park itself began at least 11,000 years ago, when the ancestors of the contemporary Shoshone began to hunt and fish in the region.
Oh, Maytan, double rotted. The city,
which you'll see dotted around the park, was a key part of their culture.
Those big island farmers, when you keep up, browsers here. I know, I just heard like 50% of what he's saying. There's so many areas. Trailhead, the gravy bubble. What's the gravy bubble? I'm curious now. We can discover this and go around. No, we can go here. We can fast travel there. Empty fork, that's what the trailhead is called. What's the trailhead? Lightning bolt into the lake will be dynamite fishing, yeah. Will be frowned upon. Take the red road. So it's spooky, though. This is a nice road. Is there a monkey here? Goddamn monkeys. This place just needs some upkeep. Invasive species. That's a good sign. Strong sign right there. Yeah, we can't really crash that hard. What? Beep, 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 beep. This is the wrong game. This is Caldwell the Angler, not the Hunter. Gotta be a Sasquatch. Gotta be. Oh, there we go. That's a new hangout spot. Hi! Call to drive you through the forest. I mean, everything's a call, you know, if you just feel it enough. Car valet, sleeping razor. We saw that, you know. Over here, there was like known fish. I haven't seen that over here. Is it just because it's not discovered? There's no sign that says you can fish here. I'm going to fish here. Or try at least. Reel it with your best shot. Oh, look over there. There were some fish. Ah! I didn't strike. I just did this shit. I didn't press anything.
Woo! There are you! Woo! Woo! Woosh! Woosh! Woosh!
I saw something earlier, but. I'm a lousy caster.
Blip fish, blip.
I don't see any more fish. I don't know, I'm doing something wrong over here. Maybe I ain't got the right lure. We should go back to more basic stuff. Back to basics. Track. It should be fine. Fast travel. Fast travel.
We really gotta stop meeting like this. You been to the rodeo yet, kid?
Rodeo?
Being a buckle bunny might do you a little good. That Sophia's a weird stick. But beating her at fishing, that dog won't hunt, Buckaroo.
Rodeo?
Oh boy, have I got a deal for you. Take a look at these.
Oh boy! Ah, there I am. I don't got any hats. Wow, it's got a lot of style to it. Vehicles, cars, all of them are Voyage Blue Rats. What about a different car? There's There's 12 different cars with the same car. No. But I want a car. Meanwhile, we got a bunch of different ones. Icevogel, Advid Harpoonen, Ankaret Screensnagger, Scransnagger. Oh, can I get a hat? Get sunglasses? I can get a hat. I mean, I got a green hat on right now. This removes your hair. We're fishing again. Damn right we're fishing again! I can't afford spinner... Do I recognize all these spinnerbaits? Spinners... Poppers, they never work. There's some frogs. Nice. Spoon, swim bait, jerk bait, crank bait. Yeah, like I know these terms now. Maybe not the spoon. Let's get top water. Techniques twitching. Now see, that's a technique. Okay, so that's what we. I'm gonna buy a frog.
Catch you later then.
Yeah, catch you
hey,
too.
It's me.
Catch you later. Hey, it's me! Not much later, is it? We must be fishing if I got my bait hat on. He's got his bait hat on. He's fishing all night long. He got no life to live. That's what Golem's got to give. Streaming on the website. Crueling on the... fuck, I lost it. I'm not a rap genius. Hardcore fishing sim from South.
It's gonna be amazing.
Come on, fish! I'm getting tired of your bullshit! Twister tails? I don't think so. I don't think I got no twister tails. Oh, maybe I should stop doing with the hot dog. I got spinnerbait. Cheese. Ooh. Mastery. Why couldn't I change? Oh. Oh, I don't have it. Okay. Yeah, minnow is the choice. Minnow or bloodworm, at least for this new area, I think. Let's go again. Let's see. One, two, and the hula maloo. Let's go. Cast this low. Hula. Oh, let's go. Cast this. Let's hell boogie. Oh, I see over there. Hula-maloo. Hula-maloo! Oh, diddle and diddle and diddle and hoodie. When you come on down to fish in town together. Ah! Strike! He worked so hard to build this town together. Rolling down in nice cold weather whenever. I don't know.
whenever.
I can't remember the song.
We're together.
There we go. I wonder what the timing is to actually throw far. The motion blur has never been used as well as it is with your reel spinning. Is the reel spinning doing that? I mean, this is a good motion blur game. Because all I do as a fishing master is blurring my movements. And you don't even see how it's possible to catch so many fish in that great manner. But how does he do it? An actual legit fishing game. But you know what, Doc? This is easier than the other fishing games, so I wouldn't say actually this is a modern one, but not actually legit. I thought it was gonna be. But it's easier. Yeah, motion blur is usually a little bit poop. It's just used everywhere. I guess that's the problem, VB. It's like motion blur gets attached to everything on screen. No. Oh, I see a fish. Come on, little dingus. Ding dong. It's like Mike Tyson's punch out. Ding! That was Double Dragon, sorry. Puddle be. Are you guys annoyed by this right now? Stop. I gotta catch 3 more fish. So musically talented, thank you. I appreciate it. What about yesterday's elusive Gaia flute, though? No, grandpa. No, the father and the flute weapon. Come here, fishy, fishy, fush. Come here, you wanking fish. Oh. Heard some. I heard some splishies beside me. Oh, was that something? No. Yes. Bing! Oh, shit. Drag was a bit much. This fish is angry. We got us an angry fish right now. I have not caught the swamp monster yet. But I'm developing swamp ass as we're speaking. And the fish is getting away. This is a tough one, chat. It's getting tired, it's getting tired. Secure catch. This has got to be a silver one. No, it's a bronze one. But it's a bigger one. We got a bass. Fish captured. Fish captured. Fish captured. Do we have my thing yet? Still? I don't know. Fish captured. I don't know. Do I? No. Where did I even save it? I don't know. Fish! Fish on, that's nice on. That's Mario Golf or whatever. Can I search for fish? I'm gonna search for fish in my folder. That's gonna work. It worked.
Fish captured. Fish captured. Fish captured. Fish captured. Fish captured. Fish captured.
I made my thumbnail for the fishing stream, and I just couldn't help but include the most important one. Oh, my face is in the way. Jimmy Houston, buddy! Jimmy Houston in the house. He's so pretty. He looks so proud of you. He is, I think he is. Small, this is what my biggest fish. My biggest fish is smallmouth bass. Now we just need to catch two more for her to be accepting us into her school of wizardry, where we can finally multiclass and get that magic. I would love a game that, like, changes. It's like, imagine a fishing game, but Doki Doki Literature Club. Okay? So imagine the twists and turns that game goes through. But it's a fishing game. So you kind of start normal, and it's like super chill, and you're fishing. And then after a while, the fish just like starts eating your line all the time, and you start inspecting more and more what's going on. And then suddenly the warden's dead. And then the tackle lady says, "We don't really know what happened. And we haven't found his body, but we got a letter that he's dead. It was written in ink. Very excessive ink. Just happens to be potentially a dangerous octopus. Turns out this whole fishing game became a Cthulhu octopus game with horror elements, and then you start to change your rod into having like blades on it. And then you get better headgear to preserve your mind so you don't get caught by the mental illness or get psychotic because of the fatang. So you get like better hats to preserve. That smile is very abnormal. Like Dredge? Yeah, like Dredge. When are we making this? We already started. I have a couple of three people who's... That makes three a few, not a couple, by the way. We always say... I always used to think that, Chad. I always was a stupid idiot. But... this was more for the Norwegian language, but the same thing kind of apply when I learned English as well, is that I used to say... A couple... in Norway, it's called et par. A pair. A couple. I didn't think that that meant two. So I would say, yeah, I got a couple of these things. I didn't necessarily imply two. Couple for me was like 2 to 4, maybe 5. And then I realized later on in life, like, that's two, isn't it? Damn. No, a few is not necessarily three. But you do go into the threshold of few after two. But yeah, it's loose. It's context sense, maybe. I mean, it could be loose if you're talking about, like, how many soldiers we got? Eh, we got a couple. You can say it like that, as in a brief, casual conversation. How many soldiers do you have to invade Luxembourg? Yeah, we got a couple of soldiers. Yeah, I had a couple of beers, you know? Yeah, it's like... But that's being loosey-goosey with the language. That's just not caring too much. But what it does mean, if you would dictionary, would be that, right? That's how I use it, not too specifically. Okay, so you just... Okay, so it wasn't... So I'm not that stupid then. I thought I was really stupid. But I'm still, I guess, different ways. English is as a language is hilariously inaccurate. Are the Norsk planning a land war? No. I didn't say anything. No, it's not worth it. We're not invading Luxembourg again. It didn't work out last time. November. November. That's when we're trying. We're not. Release the fish. One more fish. Worth another shot. It's been a long enough time now. They wouldn't expect it. They would not expect it. Strike, you're out. Oh, it's a sissy fish. It's a sissy fish. It's a silver? I got a silver one that was easier to catch. What? I guess it's just a big old rando. I got my fish. I've got my fish in the barrel. Don't skip my school in the damn. Mm-hmm. Hello, lady.
Salutations.
Bye, lady.
Beautiful day we're having.
Goodbye, beautiful day we're having. I'm not a robot. Reward. I got a cigar? Oh shit, you didn't see it in time. I got stuff. I got a cigar. I got a cigar. What's up? There's a QR code here. Visit the. I don't think it's clear enough to visit. Look at it. Very pretty game. Ooh, can we do this? Laters. Wow, it's made of titanium steel. Purely for decoration. There are no kids here. They're all eaten up by Cthulhu.
Evening. In the mood for a bargain?
She sounds so natural. Evening. In the mood for a bargain? Good work, Buckaroo. Can I please have the cigar in my mouth?
One rock.
Camo. You gotta go camo. I don't got more camo. But how do I use my cigar? Storage. I couldn't use accessory down here. It's none. What? Is it a mask? Oh, maybe it's a mask. You're right. You could be right. No. What in the world? It said cigar. Local souvenirs? Oh, maybe it's a souvenir shop? Reputation is a measure of how many missions you've completed in the reserve. Higher rep unlocks additional items for purchase in the souvenir shop. $6,000, $50,000. Sasquatch chest. But we'll be hunted. Budget Bigfoot bottoms. But I don't have... If it's local souvenirs, can I check my souvenirs? The engine numbers not be named? I like what Day 9 said yesterday. Day 9 had a very short thing about Unity. Well, he did talk a little bit about it, but I liked his opening line about it. Unity just announced that you should probably download Unreal. No, wait. What is it called? Unreal Engine, right? You should probably start downloading Unreal. Just short and sweet.
Here's what I've got.
I don't got it. I don't got anything. I don't know what the cigar was. Yeah, the thing is, every other kind of popular development company, right, or like game dev, game engine software and similar is like, ooh, this is good. Fiskespö. That's Swedish, though. Fishing crazy, basically, that means, chat. Crazy for fishing.
If you've spent any time with Old Clay, you've heard him talk about his son.
Nebdir.
One in, one out, that's the way of the world. Glad I can be here and not there.
Wyoming for fishing. Not again, her face is... more sinister. Looks like blood on her lips as well. There's the
Did
right
you know
way.
The oldest fish hooks ever were made of sea snail shells, and that's about 28,000 years old. Pretty neat, huh? Buy something next time, okay?
What do you mean the peasants are upset about us wanting more money of the money they earn? Well, the problem is. Well, first they need to clarify. I think that I haven't done my own research right now. I'm just going through osmosis. I've heard that it's up to 0.2 from per install. But still, the biggest issue is that we wouldn't have a big problem if it was basically... if we already had a cut, right? If when you used Unity, you already knew that. Unity took 1% or 2% of your total income. And that was that. You can agree to that, but the thing is, they just added in a new model.
How's the fishing going?
Hey.
Here's a blessing to catch more fish.
Yes, it's going pretty good, Kenneth. Thank you for the 100 bits. The fishing's going okay, we just finished the more fish tutorial. But yeah, for the Unity stuff, it's like, they just added this new way to take money from you, and then it will be different if they would just say, instead of 2%, we're gonna take 3.5%. And they're like, okay, you know, that's expected, but yeah, that's a bit weird. But now they have this very sketchy model. Per install,
right. We sell them.
They charge...
Welcome to Taylor's Tackles.
0.2, or whatever it was, percent.
I'll
There's a sight for sore eyes.
And then it's... They're also... The thing is, like, Unity is kind of... They made a... Somebody was asking a question on Twitter. And then Unity's response to the whole thing about, like... People were trying to clarify what you mean per install. It's like... Would it be on different devices? And said, well, we can't really say much about it, of course. So Unity was already kind of being dicks about, like, well, we can't, of course, we can't say much specifically about this thing, because he's not allowed. But, like, don't say that to a person in the community and, like, saying, like, well, it's super secret. Well, people are uproared. A bronze rank crappy. Take the tour. The golden tour. I already gone on some touring, though. Diamond Peak. It's beyond sketchy. It's weird. It's weird. Unity used to be this whole... They had community conventions supporting developers, and they did a lot of stuff just, like, be very open and friendly, and suddenly it seemed like something's changed, something's twisted. And it might not be as bad as it is, but the thing is, it's already... It doesn't really matter at this point. Right now, people are pissed. And even though, if people realize it's not as bad as it is, it could even be super, super mediocre. But the way it's been delivered is already there. And people already want to change and do things differently. They got a new CEO from EA. Duke says, John Ricciatello. You can't even pronounce his name. That's how difficult and weird this new scheme is. He's been there for 10 years. Okay. Well, then that's not a new CEO then. Maybe up in ranks. No? So that's not it. See, I haven't done my own research. Again, it's Osmosicus Maximus. Was that the only tour we did? Just across the bridge? The touring was just to go here. Oh no, there it is. Track this one. Visit the watermill. Where? Oh. But we've been there though. Yeah, we can fast travel. It's a piece of shit and I've had to personally deal with the fall of his shitty business practice. Oh yeah. You used in your previous career. Great. Sounds awesome. No, it isn't. It's not showing up on the map. Think he's behind the current scheme? Eh. Yeah, that's unfortunate.
We're here to fish, not be fish.
Not be fish.
It's unfortunate to see so many businesses fall. Like Blizzard Activision is just a weird mess. Riot Games is doing pretty well for themselves. People mention that Riot Games is like the Blizzard of old, and I like that idea. They make all the good shit. If you're into those kind of games, but they've not failed. Riot Games has made so much cool shit. Without being scummy. Whoa, where are we? Bernie the Bear says only you can prevent wildfires. He's got this coolest... Look at his damn handlebar mustache. Look at this guy. Wait, Bernie's packing. Fire danger is moderate today.
They say this park is haunted. And well, the only baloney I care to deal with is in a sandwich, if you know what I'm saying.
This just feels like Fallout.
However, if we're talking about the ghosts the logging industry left behind, I'd have to agree. There's the ghosts of men and women who lob down sweet Mother Nature's vital vitality for a toot or two. There's the ghosts of fir, juniper, and pine, took from us far, far too soon. Heck, the building itself is a ghost, once whirring with its own baleful life and energy. And look at it now, just an eerie shell where work once was. Although I'll have to ask you to stay out of there for safety reasons. Should probably remove this bit from the tape later on if I figure out how.
Well, they have internal issues, that's right. But they're making good games. Out externally. I don't know a lot about the insider issues. I only know enough that I'm just sick and tired. I'm sick and tired of hearing about all the things being fought and overreactions, and some of them are true and some of them not. But so I'm a person normally not into political stuff because of that reason alone, and the same goes for a lot of video game stuff. I just want to see products. I just want to see us work with services and products that can work. And when there comes, when there is talk about what the hell is going on internally, there's just so much reaction from both sides, and I don't want to get into it. So for me, it's mostly about talking about the surface level services. Like, what does this cost? Is this a piece of shit product? Yes or no? So that's kind of how I roll with things. And you guys that have been here for a while know that I just don't care about fucking going deep into politics or anything. Everything here is condemned and dangerous. This is so spooky, chat. Yeah, I think... well, I don't know if you're talking about Riot or Unity in the... at this point, but Unity definitely, whatever has happened. Norwegian friendship dollar. Friendship dollar? We don't have that. Hold on. The Norwegian friendship dollar was made to commemorate many years of happy friendship with the Scandinavian nation of Norway. Coin features a fjord inlet on the front and a hulking troll on the back. What the fuck is this? Huh? Is this a real thing? Norwegian friendship dollar. No. No, it's not a real... this is not a real thing. Fuck you. It's not a real thing. Sorry about the chat being in the way. Oh, those are the legendaries.
Now, do you think you can beat the champ?
I can take him blind.
What if he's not blind? For?
Goldstein. The legendary Goldstein. You can see the things. Oh, God. Let's read. Chat, go away for a moment. Goldstein. Bait and lure preference, popper, frog, crankbait, everything apparently. Before Goldstein was Goldstein, he was one half of a school of two. But they said those who spawned together, stayed together. Okay, when in this case they couldn't swim together forever. Some fishermen say it started with a glint in his eye. They could see from the shore. Others claim they saw Goldstein applying a little seasoning to his partner between strokes. Wow! Either way, he was soon found sailing solo. With a little extra weight to show for his heartbreak. What followed was a plethora of potential partners of all shapes and sizes, but the first cut was the deepest, and their first fight would be spelled to be their last. A good mate is hard to find, but a decent meal is easy, and before long, Goldstein has developed a real taste for love. None would prove to be as nutritious as his first, but as they say, there's plenty more fish in the freshwater. That's not what they say. Goldstein has no intention of giving up, no matter how big he gets. I like this lore about legendary fish. Big Larry. Whoops. Hold on. Big Larry started the same size as any other catfish. But soon, her suckling skin tasted more than just hot dogs and corn. She tasted friends, relatives, babies. She tasted more and more until none born of water could sate her. Wow, this is fucking horror. She bit hooks clean off lines, snatched planks from boat floors, polished fingers off bone, and wrenched nails from toes. Holy shit! She bit and licked and crammed and sluiced until anything missing ended Mars sign. A labeled sandwich in the communal fridge. The last pack of Chipotle cheese chips in a gift shop. Even memories of where Clayton put his shoes or a hastily made appointment to go to karaoke was said to have been swallowed by Larry. She ate on and on until her trail of tipples brought her to you. Can you serve just desserts or are you her main course? Dude, I was joking before. Remember when I said, what about if they make a twist and make it the horror game? Jesus Christ, these fish are insane. It's a baby eater fish. Not human, baby, but they're biting off anything. Polished fingers off bone and wrenched nails from toes. Oh! Big Larry! Fucked up! Sidewinder. Sidewinder drummed up rumors as a sound rather than a fish. A boom followed by ripples, knocking, and stillness. Keen fishermen would say they saw a blur. Look down with their bait clean gone. And now those days are too. Sidewinder was the pinnacle of speed. And with that, he found success. With the success comes cold, hard calories. Now Sidewinder is a behemoth-sized whopper with an uncharacteristic breakneck speed to boot. Even if he can't quite reach the sound barrier, he used to shatter to pieces. Okay. A fish that could break the sound barrier. That's pretty good. I like the lore of these insane fish. It's like a spooky fiction novel. Now it's dark. Okay. That's great. So now it's dark outside in the condemned village. And we just read about spooky legendary fish. Boo! Tombstone. It's the most dangerous place to catch fish. You think you made a settlement here in Fallform? I think so. And the hunter becomes hunted.
Dip, dip. Dip.
You bet Big Larry broke the part of the dock. Oh yeah, it was Big Larry.
Big Larry!
Oh, this is an easy fish. A gold crap black crappy. Whoa, we got 3 achievements for that. And our butter. Swallowed in the deep. The fisherman came no more. You can get achievements for doing crappies? Yeah. You can. Can get fish for doing crap. I like this nighttime fishing at the condemned village. This is so spooky. Well, this is so spooky, Chad. Crappies love hot dog. Look at the fish over there. He's happy. Come on now. Look at those happy fish, but they're a little bit too far off from me. I can try. I don't know how to get, like, throw fast, though. 20 meters. It's not far enough.
Not far enough for this.
These are good. This is a fish. Good location. So much scourge. Do I get money for this? I don't get money, though. I just gotta do more challenges. So I've caught a gold crappie. Look at that. Traits. Aggressive. Goes directly for strike without nibbling. What was his traits for the legendary ones? Night owl. More active at night. Patient. Only left soaking. Only baits left soaking in water for a while. Oh. Interesting. There's no, like, murder trait, is there? Born to hunt. High speed. Ambusher, which I've recently splashed in the water. That's so fun, man. Oh, I'm dying! You'll find out the murder trait when you get when they get you. Yeah, that's true. New traits. Murderous fish. Ah, oh, it's too late. This just looks downright spooky. If I didn't know better, chat, I was playing a new like survival horror game right now. Just look at this. There's nothing to me that tells this is a safe game right now to play. The main menu of Nuka Throne. Ah, it's such a good game, man. We played it actually recently. You know what was pretty fun? We played Nuclear Throne recently, randomly, and then we played... What was the game, chat? We played another game that had a reference to Nuclear Throne. That was so wild. That was so random. This game seems fishy to you, Spider. It would be correct. So it had the pyramid shoot thing. It was not Bashi, it was Nuclear Throne. Which game did we play? Oh, was it Raft? No. It wasn't it wasn't Super Raft together. Was it Super Raft together? It was, wasn't it? Yeah, I think it was Super Raft together. Yes. No, that's Behemoth Studios who did Castle Crashers. They're still doing Behemoth Studios over there. This guy's made his own kind of stuff and had one other dude helping him with some art, I think. Young Venus game? FPS? Well, let's call it a fish. We done exploring, we done some fishing, we got a gold crappy, got some dares, all good. Now I want to check out another new game. No more fishing hat. No more fishing hat. There's a He-Man looking game that just came out. It's called Myth Force. Let's play that after the break. I've caught about 10 fish today or more. So, again, where is it? Do I have the links or do I have the things? Oh god, my, this game is crashing my everything. That's not it. Go away, game. There we go, now it works. Here's a link to the game if you found it interesting. I'll be probably getting some keys for it to give away later on. That's your fishing call. Click the link. And now we're gonna change to, Myth Force. Alright, I'll see you after the break, everybody. That is the pyramid guy, young Venus. Okay, yeah, he was the one that wasn't super raft together. Alright! Oh, it's this button. Of course. See you in a moment, chat. Love you, appreciate you. Thank you again, Daredrop, for this sponsor segment. And now for another one from Daredrop. Coming up soon. Oh, we got a one level 10. Doomsday Man reached level 10 on the Star Trek. Twek. Okay, see you soon. Ooh. Here. There we go.
There's nothing glamorous about
weed. Hey, look at these.
Well, except for glamours.
Glamours?
It's an elvish thing.